Hello, we're on to lesson 5. This is the lesson with two word families. We're talking about ox and ob. So ox, like ox, and box, and also fox. All right, let's get started. Box. So une boîte ou un carton is box. And here we have fox, renard, fox. And here's our song. And this is The Fox by Just Dance for Kids. So this is the dance. And here's what the fox actually says. So that is what the fox says. Okay, and we have ox. So un bœuf avec les cornes. Ox, boof. And in Canada, we have musk ox. So these are musk ox. Boof musqué. So in Nunavut, we have musk ox. Still today, aujourd'hui même, il y a des boof musqué. Nunavut is in the heart of Canada's Arctic. Temperatures often reach minus 40 degrees. Musk oxen are protected by their thick coats, kept warm by their extremely soft underfur. Inuit call their warm underfur kivyut. Musk oxen live wild and free in Nunavut. They are integral to the ecosystem. So there you have it. I used to live in Nunavut. So this is me with a polar bear fur. Alors c'est la fourrure d'un ours polaire. Ça c'est dans Nunavut. And this is near the Arctic Circle. This is my father. C'est mon père. Et ça c'est moi. Et on est sur le cercle, c'est-à-dire cercle arctique, voilà. And when I was up there, I taught in a francophone school. Alors, j'étais enseignante d'anglais dans l'école qui s'appelle l'école des trois soleils, and I taught English. Very good. All right, we're on to cob. Alors, c'est une épi de maïs, cob. This is a knob. Attention, le casse est silencieux. Knob. And this is a mob. Alors, normalement, c'est une foule qui est fâchée. Mais il y a une grande exception. Alors, normalement, mob, c'est fâché. Usually, a mob is an angry crowd. So, they're angry. However, we have a flash mob, which is different. So, this is a flash mob in Vancouver. I'm from.
Thank you.
so that is a flash mob. Here's another flash mob. Alright, so that's another flash mob. Okay, so snob. You have the same word in French, snob. To rob, c'est un verbe. Des valises, ou voler. To sob, sangloter. Now we have an adjective, knobby. So when you have really, they look like door knobs, a bouton, that's knobby knees. We talk about knees being knobby, les genoux, and we also talk about knobby tires for bike tires. So these are knobby tires, these are slick, and these are knobby. Nouveau. Okay, time to review. To chop. Rocky. Caught. To drop. Sloppy. Fog. Pop. Cog. Dot. Hop. Flock. To stop. Poppy. Dog. Pop. Block, shop, not, cop, bog, pot, sock, hog, lock, slot, knock, frog, spot, mop, rock, soggy, hot, to clog, got, to jog, to shoot, shot, log, clock, to rot. All right. Goodbye, cinquième.
Bonjour. Aujourd'hui, nous allons apprendre à faire des phrases interrogatives en anglais au présent. Mais observons d'abord le français. En français, il y a trois façons de faire des questions. Travailles-tu? On inverse le verbe et le sujet. Tu travailles? On garde l'ordre de la phrase déclarative. Mais l'intonation à l'oral et le point d'interrogation à l'écrit nous renseignent sur le fait que c'est une question. Et enfin, est-ce que tu travailles avec « est-ce que » qui lance la question. En anglais, il n'y a qu'une seule façon. Et cette façon ressemble à celle avec « est-ce que ». Pourquoi? Parce que dans la question « est-ce que tu travailles ?», il y a trois parties. « Est-ce que ?», le sujet et le verbe. En anglais aussi, il y a trois parties. Il y a d'abord l'auxiliaire. Au présent simple, ce sera « do ». Le sujet. Et enfin, le verbe. « Do you work ?» Trois parties, donc. L'auxiliaire « do ». Le sujet. Et le verbe. À la troisième personne du singulier, L'auxiliaire, ce sera does. C'est lui qui porte le S de la troisième personne du singulier. Le verbe, lui, est paresseux et ne fait plus rien. Après l'auxiliaire, on met le sujet. Et enfin, le verbe, sous forme de base verbale, puisque c'est does qui porte le S. Does Tom work?
Okay, so that is the present simple. So the simple present or the present simple interrogative, that means we're asking a question. And so we have do I mop? Do you shop? Does he rob? Does she pop? Does it stop? Do we chop? Do they drop? Simple past negation is all did. So I did not knock, you did not knock, we did not knock, she did not knock, it did not knock, we did not knock, they did not knock. So that is the negation of the simple past, which we did last time. Okay, goodbye, quatrième année. Troisième année, we are talking about kiwis today. So again, you can find this audio online. And here's a little video about the kiwi bird.
Okay, we have six North Island brown kiwis here. That's the only species you will actually find outside of New Zealand. They're very bizarre, very unbird-like as far as birds go.
All right, so that is the kiwi bird. So here are some words that you need to know. So this is the stoat, and this is an incubator where they keep the egg warm, and this is a kiwi release.
Today was a pretty special day. We are releasing Rui in the Omaroa Ranges between the fox and Franz Josef Glacier Township.
So we'll head into the bush here and we'll go and find that burrow that I had a look at before.
I took a group of the Fox Glacier school kids out to release the birds.
Just want to lay your hand.
It was pretty special getting to show these guys, I guess, our native Tonga and give them a once in a lifetime chance to release them into the wild.
All right, so that is a kiwi release. So here we have saving the kiwi.
Report.
Now, listen to this month's report.
Saving the kiwi.
The kiwi is New Zealand's national bird, and New Zealanders are even called kiwis. The kiwi bird has lived in New Zealand for millions of years, but now it's in danger. That's why the kiwis are saving the kiwi.
New Zealanders unite for conservation. Today, there are around 68,000 kiwi in New Zealand. Each year, 2% of the wild kiwi population disappears. That's 27 kiwi every week. That is why, for the past 25 years, New Zealanders have been trying to save the kiwi. Community groups and volunteers are working with charities on an impressive kiwi conservation project.
Collecting kiwi eggs. In the wild, only 50% of kiwi eggs hatch, and just 10% of the chicks that do hatch live to be 6 months old. That's why a program called Operation Nest Egg was created. Volunteers monitor adult birds' movement patterns. If the kiwi is not moving because it is sitting on an egg, the volunteers collect it before a predator arrives.
Predators and other dangers. The biggest danger to the kiwi is predators. When Europeans arrived in New Zealand in the 17th century, they introduced stoats, cats, rats, and the kiwi's worst enemy, dogs. These animals cannot resist kiwi or kiwi eggs. Cars are also a big danger, which is why there are more and more road signs to tell drivers to be careful.
Ideal conditions for kiwi eggs. When the eggs are collected, they go to an incubation center. They travel in special boxes to keep them warm, then stay in incubators until they hatch. The results are positive. 80 to 90% of the eggs hatch, and 65% of chicks become adults. Volunteers also take chicks that have just hatched from the nest and keep them at the center in ideal conditions.
Special islands for kiwi. When kiwi chicks are 2 weeks old and weigh 300 grams, they leave the incubation center and go to a kiwi creche. These creches are on islands where there are no predators. But a kiwi can't spend all its life in a creche. The aim is to be independent. The people in this photo have a kiwi in a box. It is now big enough to survive in the wild.
A big day for kiwi and volunteers. This kiwi is being released into the wild. It weighs 1,200 grams and can defend itself from predators. Many people from local communities have come to watch. A kiwi release is an important moment, which shows that the Kiwi Conservation Project is a success. A chick born in the wild has just a 5% chance of surviving and becoming an adult, but a bird raised in a creche has a 65% chance.
A happy ending. Operation Nest Egg was created to increase the population of each of the 5 kiwi species by 2% each year, and it has worked. The project has been particularly successful because so many ordinary New Zealanders have participated. They have got closer to their national bird and become excellent conservationists. For the moment, the little brown kiwi is safe in New Zealand.
Box, operation, project,